Okay, so what we're going to do is, first of all, we're going to create a background on our paper. And I've got my water and my watercolour paints here ready. So for this, to create a background, it's probably a good idea to use a slightly bigger brush, put lots and lots of water on, and then just actually cover the paper in water. And then you can decide, have fun deciding which colours you would like to use. You can use any colours you want. And because you've already made the paper wet, the paint will just nicely flow and create a nice background for you. Remembering to wash the brush between choices of colour, and you can just create a nice background like this with any of the colours that you like. So it's autumn in the UK at the moment, so I'm going to use like quite bright autumnal colours. Okay, and it's quite nice. There's no right or wrong way of doing this. You can just have fun adding whichever colours you like. And if you want, you can add a bit more water to this to make it really blended nicely. You could add some bits where the paint is kind of almost splattered on, so that you get an interesting background. Okay. And if that's too much, you can always add a bit of water if you want to make it a bit more like that. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to let that dry, and while you're letting it dry, you're going to have a go at doing your continuous line portraits of each other using either a pencil or a pen. Okay, so once your background is dry, you can start drawing the person opposite you in the classroom. And the idea is, like we practiced when you were learning at home, you're going to not take the pen off the paper. Obviously, if your hand gets a little bit tired, you can take your hand off and then return it to the point where you removed it. Remember, don't worry, the drawing doesn't have to look exactly like the person you're drawing. This is more about freeing up your use of line and just getting you back into the rhythm of drawing again.